It's funny the way our scoring system facilitates one specific breed of learners. If you can sit in a chair, read, memorize, and regurgitate information, then you'll be successful. I was lucky to discover that my way of learning does in fact line up with our education system to an extent. Starting in elementary school all the way up to my current senior year, I've been able to coast through core classes, finding myself placed in programs such as SOAR, as well as other advanced class placements that somehow deemed me more intelligent than my fellow students. I've had the privilege of kicking back and enjoying my childhood, maintaining more than passable grades, all while watching my peers struggle through their years of education. It pains me to say that it gave me a bit of a condescending view over the people around me. I couldn't believe that life could be so easy, and that my success was practically guaranteed because I could ace a test after sleeping in class for a week straight. I was paralyzed in a bed of delusion for nearly 16 years, until I finally read a book and woke the hell up. By no means is schooling, whether it be elementary, middle, or high school, something we should look down upon. It teaches us free-spirited teens the value of hard work and time management. The problem I have with it is not the principles, but the content. There are brilliant young individuals everywhere that are forced to believe they are somehow less useful in society because of their C-minus average. Some of the most brilliant people I know have cringeworthy grade point averages, and their attendance record is far from honorable. The difference is these people are out accumulating a different kind of knowledge. Real skills, whether it be experimenting with the anatomy of a car, exploring new ways to make money through social networks, or even simply studying the mental frameworks of successful individuals. They're getting to know and understand their true selves. This realization alone changed my life. It provided me with an extreme sense of humility. The concept that the A I was able to get on the test didn't have shit to do with the level of success I desired to achieve was groundbreaking. I'm not going to ignore or deny the fact that my natural ability to do well in school has helped my general levels of mental health and sanity tremendously. It's provided me with a much clearer state of mind. And what I love most about it is that I can take all of my effort that I don't put into school, and I can apply it out of school. I can self-educate, do my own research, and read books that aren't assigned to me in class while still handling whatever assignments may be thrown my way. This form of learning is what has really humbled me. I read a book called The Millionaire Next Door, and immediately went from blowing my paychecks within days to feeling a sharp pain in my stomach every time I dropped $5 on a hamburger. One book alone made me feel 100 times more confident in my financial future. One book alone completely reversed my spending habits and provided a clean and comforting break from the curse that is consumerism. The real-world knowledge that determines true success is unfortunately not often found in your 11th grade chemistry classroom or in your pre-calculus course, but rather is extracted from the minds of history's most successful individuals. I find myself feasting upon an invigorating amount of applicable knowledge in Sam Walton's biography, Made in America, compared to an underwhelming sliver of brain food served to me in my intro to business class. Where one teaches me the definition of a sole proprietorship, the other provides invaluable knowledge from a man who at one point was the wealthiest and most successful businessman in this country. This black and white tendency even finds its way into higher education. I once interviewed a man named Evan Corns, a man who started his company from scratch with $100,000, $40,000 was his and $60,000 was his parents, and sold it some 20 years later for $88 million. When I asked this man what he recommended I study, he looked me straight in the eye and said, "Ethan, I haven't read a goddamn business book in my entire life. I've majored in history, and I learned everything I know about leadership from the Civil War generals I was so crazy about studying. A business major won't determine your success in business. A science major won't determine your success as a scientist. All of these titles people like to put on things mean nothing. It's about the knowledge you acquire and your ability to apply that knowledge. I invite you all to learn from this lesson. Stop putting so much stress on the grades, on the major, on the test scores, and start focusing on real-world knowledge. The minute I began to reap the benefits from this real-world knowledge, although small, it's like I became addicted to learning more." I want to clarify once more that schooling is not the enemy. People just need to understand that it can be a black and white institution in an incredibly abstract and complex world. Just because you can get a 36 on your ACT does not mean that you will change the world. Good grades and good test scores, of course, are something we should all strive for, simply because that is how the system works. But if we as young people fail to take it upon ourselves to learn from the great people around us, whether through books, interviews, podcasts, etc., then we will suffer the consequences of our artificial, delusional sense of self-righteousness and prolific enlightenment planted into our heads by our straight-A report card. The day I woke up and read a book, a world of opportunity unveiled itself to me. The more you know, the more you realize and understand you don't know. An extraordinary sense of humility is what separates those of us who prosper from those who find themselves stuck in the machine. That and an unmatched enthusiasm for their own past, present, and future. I wake up every day with a fire in my stomach ready to take on whatever the universe wants to throw at me. And I love and cherish every single goddamn minute of it. I invite you all to do the same.